and Walmart has temporarily closed about 60 stores for sanitizing against the CCP virus. In December, the retailer closed dozens of stores for 2 days, mostly across Texas and New Jersey. They have yet to comment on whether there was an outbreak at any of these locations. Last week, Apple closed its stores in New York City amid the surge of Omicron. Ahead of the anniversary of the January 6th breach of the U.S. Capitol, the Board of the Capitol Police outlined the measures it is taking to enhance the long-term security of the Capitol grounds.
The United States Capitol Police, as an organization, is stronger and better prepared to carry out its mission today than it was before January 6th of last year.
In a press briefing, the Capitol Police Chief talked about some of the major changes that have already taken place within the agency.
For the past year, our focus has been implementing improvements that would provide our officers with the resources that they need to fulfill their responsibilities safely and effectively.
Manger said that they've received dozens of reports with over 100 recommendations since last year.
We've improved the way that we gather, analyze, share, and use, and disseminate intelligence. We've brought on an operational planning expert from the United States Secret Service to develop a blueprint for handling large events with a focus on intelligence, assets, and coordination both internally and with our outside partners as well.
Manger also said that they're providing in-person briefings for uniform officers before major events and providing cell phones for all officers so that they can receive daily intelligence and operation information. They also expanded officer safety and wellness initiatives and improved public communication. In the January 6th breach last year, leadership at the Capitol Police came under hard criticism. The agency had underwent leadership changes, as well as increased funding, and made what they referred to as internal adjustments. However, the most pressing issue the force still faces is staffing. Manger told Fox News earlier that they're short of about 400 officers after a surge of retirements and resignations in the wake of the January 6th Capitol breach. On Monday, the Department of Justice announced a new rule requiring firearm merchants to have gun storage and safety devices on site for their customers. Attorney General Merrick Garland said it would help prevent guns from falling into the wrong hands. This rule came 1 month after the parents of school shooting suspect Ethan Crumbley had been arrested for involuntary manslaughter. They're accused of making the gun accessible to their teenage son and not doing anything to intervene. The gun was stored in an unlocked drawer. In November, American workers quit their jobs at record numbers. According to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, over 4.5 million Americans quit their jobs in November. The drop-offs increased in several industries, including food services, healthcare, and transportation. Meanwhile, job openings declined to over 10 million. Yet the number of job vacancies increased throughout finance, insurance, and government sectors. And with all that piled up snow, folks in the nation's capital made the best of it with a giant snowball fight on the National Mall.
Today we're letting it all loose on unsuspecting adults.
They're calling it the Battle of Snowmacron, trying to find some lightheartedness in a city that is facing a wide range of pandemic measures. It got pretty intense, too. Opposing armies of snowball fighters faced off on DC's National Mall. Adults and kids making the most of this first storm of the year.
Yeah. We haven't done it before, but I heard on the radio that it was happening. And we were like 20 minutes away in Alexandria. So I was like, you know what? Let's go.
They made use of the National Mall's wide open space. Each side took turns in an epic battle against the backdrop of the Smithsonian Castle. A fun way to kick off the new year. For some, the snowball fight offered a nice change of pace from their regular routine.
Well, we got a bunch of snow, and then Bailey texted me after we both slept in and said, what are you doing? Let's go to the snowball fight. So I got all my stuff out of the closet, got all suited up, and came down here.
The battle was organized by a DC Facebook group called the Washington, DC Snowball Fight Association. If you're in DC for the next snowstorm, stay on the lookout for more fun snowball fights.